lightning fast internet on 12 volt. I'm going to show you how to connect your existing Starlink Gen 2 or Gen 3 to a 12 volt system. It's plug and play, no cutting wires. Basically, if your RV has a cigarette lighter plug, you're good to go. It's 12 or 24 volt. It's very easy to install. I could even get Sandy to do it. Xtar-link reached out to us and asked if we would take a look at their DC conversion kit for our Gen 2 Starlink. It arrived about 4 weeks ago, and I've been comparing it with our existing setup to see how it stacks up. So in this video, we're going to look at what's in the box, how to connect it to Starlink, the pros, the cons, price, where to buy it, and a discount code that gets you up to $40 off, and our thoughts after 4 weeks using it. I do need to mention they supplied this to us free of charge, but rest assured we'll give you my honest opinion on whether it's any good or not. Spoiler alert, it's priced well, easy to set up, and works flawlessly. There you go, you don't have to watch any more of this video. But if you'd like a discount, then you'd better stick around till the end. This is me unboxing it when it arrived. I was a bit excited, and I apologise now because parts of this video are a bit embarrassing. Righto. Okay, Greg here, Kiwi Wanderers. I've got a package from Hong Kong. Let's just see what's in it, shall we? Sandy's let me have the scissors. Obviously, she's supervising in the background, because I'm not allowed sharp implements by myself. Oh, well packaged. Can't even get into it. This is exciting, just like Christmas. And then, oh wow. This is, this is a 12 volt system for the Starlink. Oh, exciting. This company from Hong Kong reached out to me and said, would you like to, or could you test for us our new 12 volt DC conversion for Starlink? And so they sent me, wow, that's a nice looking bit of kit, isn't it? Xtar, they are, that's the company. And there's a number of different ways you can run it, and here, that's all set up beautifully, isn't it? Oh, kind of look forward to trying this out. And this will be the adapter for the Starlink cord. Wow. And some instructions. Oh, good. Look at that. Beautiful. It's fantastic.
Lovely.
And what else we got in here? Oh, and they've also sent a modem. Oh, look at it. Just, you never have too many modems, can you? Oh, woo, good jeepers. Yeah, Wi-Fi 6. Well, that could be good, couldn't it? All right, let's get it connected. Righto, today we're going to show you how easy it is to connect up the Xtar-link 12 volt power supply. Really, really easy. Here we've got the standard Starlink router. Just working away merrily on 240 volts, obviously plugged into the caravan. So we're gonna disconnect that, plug everything in, and show you how it works on 12 volts. Here we are. First things first, you need to disconnect the power. So we'll do that. And then we need to disconnect the lead that goes off to the dish. And you'll notice it has a weird looking connector on there. That is a Starlink special, that's for real. So to change that, we use Xtar-link provided us with this little gizmo here. So you plug that in, pretty straightforward. So as I said, it's pretty straightforward if you get it around the right way. there we go. So we've now got a normal connector. Then, I should be showing you the instructions before we do anything, actually. So there we are, that's the instructions. What I like about those instructions is they're nice and straightforward. Even I can understand it. Right, so now we get this little bad boy, which is the guts of it. Nice, solidly built bit of gear. And we're going to plug in. Let's have a look. Blah, blah, blah. Yep, straightforward. Plug it in like that. Once again, all the power off before we do anything. Now we need to power up our DC conversion. It has one of these little Anderson plugs that you can't get wrong, so plug it in like that. And that will go to cigarette lighter when we're all sorted. We also, because we've taken away the Starlink router, we need to have our own router. They supply in the kit they supplied, they comes with a Wi-Fi 6 dual band router, so we need to connect that to our, it's got a LAN there, and this guy will have a LAN here somewhere. Right, so that's those two connected, and then we obviously need to power up our new Wi-Fi router, sitting in there, and in there. Everything looks good. I happen to have a cigarette lighter plug here in my little cabinet, so plug that in there, and we'll turn it on. Good sign, it's got a green light, and hopefully the router will work in a minute. And here we go, green lights and stuff. The other thing I'll mention is if you don't have a cigarette lighter, or like us, the cigarette lighter power fluctuates quite a bit, you can go straight to the battery, and they supply you this lead, has the Anderson plug to go in there, and fused, got a 20 amp fuse in there. Right, and so all you have to do is connect that up to the battery. Now, I'm pretty sure everybody knows that red goes to positive. Sandy, if I've got a red wire and a black wire, what wire goes to the positive battery terminal? The red one. Good, see, everybody knows, even Sandy. Right, so there we are. I'll just wait for a minute and see what speeds we have.
Wow, look at that speed on 12 volts. Very happy.
And cons, pros, ease of connection. I've seen all sorts of videos on YouTube about running Starlink on 12 volts, but almost all involve running wires to a device or modifying cables or even cutting into the dish itself. Now, I love that sort of stuff, but I realise not everyone wants to hack into their Starlink to run it on 12 volts. This system works well because it's truly plug and play. Number two pro is keep your Starlink warranty. Since you're not modifying the Starlink in any way, you're keeping the kit in its original state, your Starlink warranty remains valid. That warranty is, I believe, 12 months. It's well made, it's solid, and all the leads and components appear to be of really good quality. The next one is power usage. I've compared the power usage of my Starlink in another video, I'll link that up the top. On the inverter, it uses about 180 to 80 watts, depending on what inverter you're running. On 12 volts, it uses about 30 watts. I also did a power comparison with my existing 12 volt system. I used the same wiring for both systems, so my communication cupboard is pretty congested now. For this comparison, I put my van in sleep mode, where only the fridge and the toilet are powered up. It was sitting at around 17 watts. Then I switched on Starlink and ran a speed test once it was booted up. The comparison was very similar. My existing system used a few more watts than Xtar-link during the speed test, but apart from that, they were very similar. So that's great. This new kit really cuts the mustard and might save a little more power than my old system. Cons. Honestly, there aren't many. The only issue we've encountered is that the power to our cigarette lighter socket isn't consistent. If we have a lot of 12 volt devices running, the Xtar-link can trip out because it hasn't got enough power and it reboots. This isn't really a Xtar-link problem, it's more of a 12 volt wiring issue. The wiring isn't heavy enough to the cigarette lighter plugs, and there's too much voltage drop. if you want to know what voltage drop is, just Google it. It basically means the bigger the wire, the better. However, Xtar-link does supply a lead in case you don't have a cigarette lighter in your RV. This lead is fused and uses good size wiring to minimize the voltage drop. So that's the only con really we've found so far. And it's not really a con. Price, you can buy this directly from Xtar-link's website, and there's a couple of options. You can get it with the modem, which seems to offer reasonable range and speed, or you can use your own modem. However, if you use your own modem, it'll need to be 12 volts and you might have to buy a lead to power it. My advice would be to go with the included modem if you want true plug and play. It adds about 40 New Zealand dollars to the kit, which is good buying for a modem. There's also a plastic housing option instead of the metal one. Xtar-link tells me there's no difference in the internal components. The plastic option is cheaper because it's easier to manufacture. So the plastic one should be fine if you're installing it in a nice sheltered area. If you're into full off-road use, then maybe you should go for the metal one.
Okay, so now the good bit, the discount code. So I'm going to give you a couple of different ways to get the discount code. You either click on the QR on the screen if you're watching on TV, or there'll be a link in the description. Oh, and if you're signing up for Starlink, a new sign up for Starlink, use the link in the description or this QR code and you'll get a month's free, which could be a couple of $100. So that is well worthwhile.
My final thoughts. This kit gets a big thumbs up from me. I wish it had been around 2 years ago when I converted my Starlink to 12 volt. Okay, so that's it. We've got some great videos coming up, testing a new reversing camera and looking at what's involved in servicing your caravan. Hey, thanks for watching everyone. Catch you out there.